So, I'll start with Windows 10, and I will open a terminal for reference. Now, if we go to power, and shutdown, Windows will immediately reboot without any confirmation dialog. But what I want to show you here, is when there is a system dialog that will be always a full screen modal. So if Windows 10 had a shutdown confirmation, it would most probably look something like that. On Plasma, I again open a terminal, go to menu, and I click on shutdown. And again, we get a full screen confirmation, that actually gives us all the rest options, so it doesn't really matter what action we press on menu. GNOME's turn, and we open a terminal again, we go to panels menu, and we click on power off. And again, we get a full screen confirmation. On elementary, we open a terminal, we go to user menu on wing panel, and we press shutdown. But this time, the confirmation dialog is actually a window that is always on top, and so we can move it. Actually, we can even move the window behind. And we can even open new windows from dock. That's a design I never understood, and I have mentioned it on some of my previous videos. But everything will make sense in a bit. Catalina's time, and we open a terminal, we go to system menu, and we do shutdown. And we now get this confirmation, that we can move around for a god knows why. And we can move the windows behind it, or open new windows from dock. Do all those remind you of something? To be fair, this design has some advantages, like performing some last second actions, but still it looks bad and fragile. To start with, when people say that elementary is an alternative to macOS, they are retarded idiots that can't tell the difference between black and white. The only workflow similarity of two desktops, is how both are failing on multitasking and when we need to work with 7 to 8 windows at the same time. However, elementary is clearly attempting to mimic some UX things from macOS, in a degree that it is at least embarrassing, especially when you're obviously trying and failing it. There are hundreds of similarities and the thing is, it is not only the official elementary that copies macOS, but even their community copy macOS community apps. To make it clear, I'm not blaming elementary for reusing macOS design, that's the open source spirit anyway. I'm just observing. In fact, I have a nice proposition to make. They can move from California to China and rebrand Apple. And bonus? Cheaper salaries too. GNOME on the other side also uses macOS patterns, but they've added lots of Android elements inside, so they have gotten away from the direct comparison. Actually, most people blame GNOME for being too much touch-oriented,